Good morning, students. As you all know, that our two chapters, that is integers and then fractions and decimals, we have already done. Now it's time to move to the third chapter, and the next chapter is exponents and powers, very important chapter. So now let's start the chapter exponents and powers. Good morning, students. So as we know that we have completed two chapters, now let's move to the third chapter, and that is exponents and powers. We have already discussed the basics of the exponents and powers in the previous class, and now let's again discuss what you mean by the term exponent and how it is related to power. For example, if we have written 10 multiply 10 multiply 10 multiply 10 means we have multiplied 10 four times. So how can we write it? 10 raised to the power 4. Power means 10 raised to the power 4, or you can say here the exponent is 4. 10 here is called the base and 4 is the exponent. And 4 is the exponent and 10 is the base. So this is the basic introduction, and in this video we will only do the introduction and some laws related to the exponents. So here it is, the 4 will be termed as the exponent and 10 is the base. For example, if a multiply a multiply a is given, and we have to find the base as well as the exponent, so we will write it as a raised to the power 3, and here a is the base and 3 is the exponent. Now let's move further. If we have to find 3 raised to the power 3 plus 4 raised to the power 4, how will we find this? This is the basic question of the simplification on the basis of exponents and the powers. 3 raised to the power 3 means we have to multiply 3 3 times, plus 4 raised to the power 4 means we have to multiply 4 4 times, that is 4 multiply 4 multiply 4 multiply 4. So 3 multiply 3, that is 9, 9 multiply 3 is 27, plus 4 multiply 4 is 16, 16 multiply 4, that is 64, and 64 multiply 4, that is 256. 64 multiply 4, that is 256, and now we have to add 27 plus 256, and that will come out to be 283. So 3 raised to the power 3 plus 4 raised to the power 4 can be written as 283. There is a question like, we have to express, for example, 256 is here, and we have to express it in the form of its exponents. So how we will do this? First of all, we will do the prime factorization of it. 256, for example, 2 is here, so 126 will come, 1 28 will come here, then 2 is here, 64 will come, then 2 is here, 32, then 2 is here, 16, then 2 is here, 8, 2 is here, 4, 2, and that is 1. So what the question is, that we have to write 256 in the form of its exponents. So 256 can be written as 2 multiply 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So 2 multiply 2, multiply 2, multiply 2, multiply 2, multiply 2, multiply 2, and multiply 2. So 256 can be written as, what we have done here, we have multiplied 2 8 times. So 2 raised to the power 8. So therefore 256 can be expressed in the form of, or you can say in the term of its exponents, as 2 raised to the power 8, and here 2 is the base and 8 is the exponent. So this is the first step of the question. Now let's move further. Next question, or you can say the next type of the simplification. For example, it is given 3 raised to the power 4 divided by 3 raised to the power 2. Here it is in the form of division. The exponents are in the form of division. So how can you do this? By the basic methods, 3 multiply 3 multiply 3
multiply 3. You can write 3 raised to the power 4 as 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 because you are multiplying the 3 4 times divided by. Here 3 square means 3 multiply 3. Now this 3 will cut and this 3 will cut. So 3 multiply 3 answer comes out to be the 9. So these are the some basic questions, or you can say the basics of exponents and powers. Now let's move to the next topic, that is the most important topic. Without that we cannot do the sums based on the identity of the exponents, and these are called the law of exponents. Very important, this is law of exponents. You can say laws of exponents. What are these laws? First of all, see here carefully. If we have two numbers, for example, a raised to the power m multiply a raised to the power m. If two numbers have the exponents a, m and n, and the bases are the same, bases are same and exponents are different, that is m and n. So it can be written like a raised to the power m plus n. So in multiplication, the exponents will add and base will remain the same. Example, 5 raised to the power 6 multiply 5 raised to the power 2. How we will do this? 5 will remain as it is and exponents will be added, that is 6 plus 2, so 5 raised to the power 8. This is the first law. Now second law, a raised to the power m divided by a raised to the power n. Here it was multiplication and now it is division, so it will be a raised to the power m minus n. In the division we will write as a raised to the power m minus m. A is the base. For example, see 5 raised to the power 6 divided by 5 square, it will be written as 5 is the base, it will remain the same, and m minus n, that is 6 minus 2, so that is 5 raised to the power 4, and that is 5 multiply 5 multiply 5 multiply 5, 5 multiply 5 25 multiply 25, so that is 625. So first is a raised to the power m multiply a raised to the power n. Second, that is a raised to the power m plus n. When multiplication is there, we will add the exponents, and when division is there, we will subtract the exponents. Let's see third, a raised to the power m whole power n will be written as a raised to the power m multiply a raised to the power m whole power m. For example, the exponent of a is m and the whole exponent is n, then it is written in the form of a raised to the power m multiply n. For example, 5 raised to the power 6 whole power 2. So here it can be written as 5 raised to the power 6 multiply 2. So that is 5 raised to the power 12. 5 raised to the power 12 is the answer. Now fourth law of exponent is, any number that raised to the power 0, any number that raised to the power 0, for example, a raised to the power 0. A raised to the power 0 means here the exponent is 0. When any number comes out to be there and whose power, or you can say exponent, the value of the exponent is 0, then always the answer will be comes out as 1. See how, for example, let's see the question based on this. 2 raised to the power 0 plus 3 raised to the power 0 plus 4 raised to the power 0. We have to find the answer. So anything that raised to the power 0, any number that raised to the power 0 will always comes out to be 1 plus 1 plus 1. So answer will be 3. Next law, that is the fifth, a raised to the power minus 1. See here, a raised to the power minus 1 means if the exponent is in the negative form, then how we will write this like 1 upon a. We will write the reciprocal of that number, or you can see the example is, if a raised to the power minus 3, how will you write it? You will write it a raised to the power a cube. Here a1, see some question in this, find the value of 5 raised to the power minus 3. So how will you find? So 5 raised to the power 3 can be written as in the form of reciprocal, so 1 upon 5, and now the exponent will comes out to be the positive. Why we have written like this? We have written like this in order to remove the negative sign and in order to get the positive sign. So while we have to remove the negative sign, we take the reciprocal. So 1 upon 5 raised to the power 3. So 1 upon 5 multiply 5 multiply 5. So that is 1 upon 125 is the answer. So these are the laws of exponents. We have discussed the 5 laws and few examples based on this. And this is the introduction part that we have done. So in this video, basically what we have covered, we have done the introduction of exponents and the powers and the 5 laws. The first law is a raised to the power m into a raised to the power n. Second is a raised to the power m divided by. Third, a raised to the power m whole power n. Fourth is anything that raised to the power 0 will always be equal to 1. And the fifth, this reciprocal. When the exponent is in the negative integer, you can say exponent is in the form of negative integer. So what we have to do, we have to convert it into the positive by writing it into the form of reciprocal. So do practice the questions, and that is one type of the question, how to write a number in the form of its exponents. So do practice the questions on this and focus on these laws of exponents, because in the coming video or in the next video we will do the questions based on simplification, and in those simplification questions these laws of exponents will be very helpful. So learn all the laws and the examples with them. So do always try to do the revision by writing. Avoid learning in mathematics especially. So learning is not an option here. You have to practice the questions and practice more and more questions. Thank you.